All right, Shalom, Yashirala. Back again with another Lord with an edifying video through the Spirit and the power of Yahabba Shimiyah Shai. Before beginning this lesson, I want to give all honor, glory, and praises to the Heavenly Father and to His only begotten Son, Yahweh Shimiyah Shai, Bashim, Rakakwadash. And next up, the honors to the apostles and to the elders of Great Millstone for teaching us the truth according to the Bible, and we'll still go out there to the highways and byways and preach the truth according to the Bible. And peace, blessings, and safety, and mercy to your Akims out there, listening to you in the four corners of the earth with boldness, righteousness, and in sincerity. And I just want to make another quick video through the Spirit of Power of Yahabah Shimeon Shiloh. When this video be edifying, you know, in Proverbs chapter 10, verse 23, it is a sport for a fool. I mean, sucker, it is sport to a fool to do mischief, man. Right? It is sport to a fool to do mischief, man, which is evil, man. You know what I mean? And what's doing evil? Transgressing the laws of Yahabah Shimeon Shai willfully, man. You know, that's doing evil, man. Accepting the ways of America, condoning homosexuality, saying there's nothing wrong with it, agreeing with it, justifying it. You know what I mean? It's a sport for you people, you idiots, to do mischief, man, in the sight of Yahabah Shimeon Shai, man. Even when you know that it's wrong, you still condone it. You know what I mean? You know what I mean? You know, he compared it to sports, man. So King Solomon compared the mischief of you fools to sports, man. In sports, what do you do in sports, man? You work hard, man. You work hard, you work hard, you work hard. You know what I mean? You increasing. You know what I mean? You're increasing, man. You know, that's exactly the sins of these two-thirds of you Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans who sin willfully, man. You know, not turn it back to you. How about Shimon Shah to the best of your ability, man? It's a sport to you, man. You know what I mean? You two-thirds of Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. You're a buff in the spirit, man. And it's in your wickedness, man, and your sins, you are buff people, man. You are muscle heads, man. You know, in the spirit, man. You know? Because you're doing evil in the sight of your high by Shimon Shah. And you know that you know what you're doing is wrong. Like, for instance, smoking cigarettes or smoking weed. In your spirit, you know that that's wrong, man. You know that it's wrong to do that because you'll say, oh, well, I need to stop doing it. You know what I'm saying? I need to stop doing it. I need to stop smoking weed. And also, it's against the scriptures, man. You know what I mean? You defile your temple. You're not supposed to defile your temple. You know what I'm saying? You know? And also, that's a heathen custom. The scripture says in Jeremiah the 10th chapter to learn not the way of the heathens, man. You know? So, with that being said, we're going to read on. But a man of understanding have wisdom. But a man of understanding have wisdom, man. And who is that man? Let's talk about the elect, man. You know, which we're hopefully, Lord willing, would be. You know what I mean? The righteous, man. You know? We have understanding of wisdom. And what understanding is it talking about? Is it talking about the understanding of how to bake a cake? Is it talking about the understanding of how to smoke weed? How to French inhale? How to blow them stupid O's, man? How to thicken the smoke out your mouth? How to what they call that crap, man? A ghost, yeah, a ghost, man, which is pretty much a French in hell. And they talk about the wisdom of that, man. And they talk about the wisdom of getting $1 million. Is it talk about the wisdom of how to flip coke? How to sell drugs, man. You know what I mean? How to mix different chemicals and stuff like that to get a chemical reaction so that it makes the person who's doing that drug more addicted to it, man. You know what I mean? No. Let's talk about, yeah, wisdom and knowledge and understanding of these scriptures, man. He know the breakdowns of these scriptures, man. And also, he's applying it. He's practicing what he's preaching, man. You know what I'm saying? He have an understanding of the things that's about to come to pass, man. The prophecies, man. The prophecies. He understands what's happened before, and he understands what's happened in the present, and he knows what's going to happen in the future, man. He has an understanding of these scriptures, man. The history, the breakdowns. You know what I'm saying? The ways of it, man. How to apply it. You know what I mean? The herbs. You know what I mean? The foods that they eat to keep them stable, man. You know what I mean? The herbs, the different herbs. He have understanding of these scriptures, man. You know what I mean? Not the Book of the Dead, not the Book of the Mormon, or any other book. It's talk about the Bible, man. He have understanding of the Bible. You know what I mean? Which is the only true living book, man. You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? That's what a man of understanding has, man. But you two-thirds of Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, you're a bunch of fools, man. And it's a sport for you to do evil, man. You know what I mean? It just increases. You get better at it. That's what I meant to say. You get better at it. You get better at being sinful, man. Sleeping with the next man's woman. You know all the tools to do wickedness, man. But then you just get better at it. You get better at it. That's why your destruction is going to be, you're going to get it, man. Your destruction is going to be horrifying, man. You know what I mean? We're going to sit back and we're going to laugh at you. You know what I mean? Because it's a sport for you to do evil in the sight of your high body, Shimon Shai, willfully, man. You know what I'm saying? Get better at it. Get better at sleeping with the next man's wife. Get better at eating pork, shrimp, crab, and lobster. You get better at getting lineups. You get better at doing all these different things, all the things that Yahweh Shimon Shai hates at it. You two-thirds, your Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans who don't follow the scriptures to the best of your ability and acknowledge that you're a Hebrew Israelite. Your sins, your wickedness, man, gets better, man. You increase in it. You get better at it. You don't get better in righteousness to the best of your ability. You get wicked, man. You get better at being wicked, man. You know what I mean? That's why your destruction is a must, man. You two-thirds Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, your destruction must be a must, man. Your destruction must be gruesome as possible, man. You know what I mean? The most violent way. You know what I'm saying? So if that, Lord willing, this video was edifying for you Akims out there, through the spirit, probably, how about Shimon Shai? Before I begin this lesson, I want to give all honor, glory, and praises to the Heavenly Father and to His only begotten Son, Yahweh, Ba'ashim, Yahweh Shai, Ba'ashim, Raka, Kodash. And next up, the honor to the apostles and to the elders of Great Millstone, who still go out there to the highways of Bible to preach the truth according to the Bible and rule well. And peace, blessings, and safety, and mercy to your Akims out there, pushing the truth in the four corners of the earth with boldness, righteousness, and in sincerity. And you confusion their faces, you better get right too. And start acknowledging that you're a Hebrew Israelites. Because your time is coming too. Where you're going to be destroyed, man. And your wickedness too. To confusion their faces. Because you're Israelites as well. Don't think you're excluded. You know? Shalom.